Good afternoon, friends. This is Dr. Abhiruchi Gupta once again from Partha Dental, Hyderabad, India. My name is Dr. Abhiruchi Gupta. I have a 17 years of work experience. I have been working for Partha Dental organization for the past 4 years. If you want to come and meet me directly, I am located particularly at the Partha Dental Gachibowli branch. In my 17 years of work experience, we have done a lot of multidisciplinary approach treatments. Partha Dental is now a global icon in the emerging dental industry. Partha Dental currently has 84 branches, and we are soon expanding to 200 branches by the end of the year 2018. The various branches of Partha Dental are located in the 3 states of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, and Karnataka. We have around 15 branches in Bangalore. We have around 40 branches in Telangana, and we have around 30 branches in Andhra. Serving each and every section of the society, each and every strata of people, we are located not only in the cosmopolitan or the metropolitan cities, but we are trying to spread our wings in all the districts, in all the cities, so that we can serve people, we can create that awareness of good dental hygiene, we can create that awareness that a healthy mouth is a healthy body. So this weekend we have the movie Padman that's released. It's on menstrual hygiene. I think one day we will definitely also have a movie on dental hygiene. I really hope such day comes that we do have such innovations. I think really it's interesting. A lot of social taboos and a lot of things are being broken, I think, by our industry as well. So Partha Dental has the highest number of implants. Our team of super specialists, I would say, implantologists and oral maxillofacial surgeons, we have a very good team of these doctors who can give or render treatments in a very perfectionist way. The implant success of Partha Dental has been 95%. We are proud to say that. We are proud to say that Partha Dental has the highest number of implants done in India from our organization. Now, similarly, Partha Dental has the highest number of orthodontics or the braces cases that we have. Hello, friends. Thank you here for joining us. We have a question here from Mr. Babu Bhai. He has a root canal. Can he go for implants? Which is the best root canal cap or implant to tell me? Thank you for asking this question. Now, a patient who already has a root canal done, usually after a root canal, a tooth becomes brittle. It's apt to break. In a root canal, the nerve supply and the blood supply is completely cut off, and we clean up the canals and we fill the canals with an inert material called gutta percha. So once a root canal is completely done, we like to reinforce the tooth, or we like to reinforce the tooth with a cap or a crown. Okay, there are different types of caps or crowns. I think that is what he is asking us. There are different types of crowns or bridges that we have. The very basic ones was something called as PFMs, or porcelain fused to metal. Let me show you something over here. So this is a bridge which is basically, if you can see over here, this is metal below, and it has this white porcelain layer on top, right? So porcelain basically covers the aesthetic part, and the metal layer is what gives the strength part. So this is a yesteryear's technology again, I would say, porcelain fused to metal, where the porcelain layer is fused to the metal. of course, it is disadvantages in a couple of ways that metal touches the gum, so it's not perfectly biocompatible. Yes, sometimes there is a fracture of the porcelain from the metal layer, so you need to get it changed again. So that's the reason. There's another type of cap called as zirconia caps, which were introduced in the dental world. Let me see if I have a zirconia cap here for you. So if you see this bridge here, there is no metal framework below at all. Okay, so this is made up of zirconia. Zirconia is really a biocompatible material. Biocompatible simply means very good for your gums, very good for your dental health. And zirconia is also made with CAD/CAM technology, very, very precise technology which takes care of each and every gradation. Hence, a very good fit of the crown. So, I hope I can answer your question. So, we have two types of I also see a lot of patients coming in with those silver caps, okay, the silver or the metal caps. Yes, they were there, but now they are obsolete. So a lot of patients, when they come here to Partha Dental, we guide them to get these type of metal caps changed. The disadvantage is, of course, the major one is that it grinds or it leads to a lot of damage on the opposite side tooth. The metal caps, when you have a continuous grinding or a chewing movement, you continuously. So that's the reason the metal cap which is there, it causes a lot of damage on the opposite side, natural tooth surface. Hence, metal caps are completely obsolete in today's world. We will definitely advocate zirconia crowns or porcelain fused metal crowns. I have another question here, Richa Nirmal. Thank you, Richa Nirmal, for joining us. Thank you, Abhiram. Thank you, Nagamalai. Can you tell us about laminates? Yes, that's a good question, Richa. Laminates are again a completely cosmetic work that is done for mostly anterior teeth, so that the minimal invasive procedure which is done for giving a beautiful cosmetic smile, right? So let me show you some image of laminates here. Dental laminates are used completely, dental laminates or dental veneers, they are used, in such type of cases. For example, somebody who has fluorosis stains, somebody who has very minimal, tetracycline bands. If my viewers can appreciate it here, sometimes there is very mild spacing in between the teeth where the patient does not have time for going on for braces or clip treatments. Sometimes the patient has fluorosis stains or white or brownish patches in the front teeth. Sometimes there could be some tetracycline bands. So in such cases, instead of doing full crowns, instead of grinding away your enamel completely on all the sides, we prefer veneers or laminates. There is a minimal preparation that is required, maybe hardly about 1 millimeter. And as it's shown in the second image here, there is a minimal preparation that is required for laminates. And then we send it to a laboratory. And the lab prepares the laminate surface for us, and then we can bond it onto the tooth. Interestingly, my topic for today is also related to labs, the lab work or the lab processes that we can that the patients can actually take advantage of. There are a lot of processes that are made in the labs. Our labs. We have tie-ups with excellent labs of India. A lot of success of our processes and of our work depends a lot on the lab. So there has to be a clear communication with the lab person and the dentist and the doctor, and so that we are able to deliver perfect processes for our patients. So my talk today is also a lot about the lab work that can be done and can help our patients. It's about night guards, it's about sports mouth guards, it's about snoring devices, it's about the orthodontic retainers that we deliver to our patients after the orthodontic treatment is complete. It's about bleaching trays, you know, they are fabricated in the labs. And of course, it's about the crowns, bridges that are given over root canal treated teeth or implants, right? Thank you everyone for joining us here. This is Dr. Abhiruchi Gupta working for Partha Dental for the past 4 years. Partha Dental is an emerging global icon in the dental industry. To get any of your dental treatments done, if you have any kind of doubts, you are most welcome to have a direct consultation with our specialist doctors. We are a team of 250 specialist doctors and 1,000 plus supporting staff. Well, I must say that success of our practice depends a lot on our supporting staff, our receptionists, our dental assistants, our housekeeping people, our lab people, our call center people. So this supporting staff is a big infrastructure that we have created at Partha Dental for the smooth running and the convenient practice that we all would like to have. You can always walk in, always take appointments at these numbers. We have a direct number, which is 040-4142-0000. Our toll-free number is 1-800-102-8686. And we also have a WhatsApp chat number, which is 8500-779-000. I'll repeat this number, 85000-779000. You can also log into parthadental.com and, you know, block your appointments. All our patients, our dental tourism patients, this is what they do. They take appointments on our website at parthadental.com and then we can, you know, treat them further. I have a couple of questions here. They're thinking of an implant instead of keeping a root canal cap. Give me a suggestion. Which is the better option, keeping root canal or go for implant? Well, the indications are different for implants and root canals. Definitely, if your tooth can be saved, if your original tooth can be saved by doing a root canal and a crown, it is anytime better to undergo that procedure. Implants are advised if the tooth is completely carious and if the tooth structure is completely lost and we have to remove that tooth and we have to replace your original tooth. Given an option, if you are able to save your original tooth with a root canal and a crown, please go ahead with that. Okay. Another question. Hello, my wife complains that I snore a lot and I grind my teeth. Well, I have complete sympathy, Mr. Rahim. That's another question, another topic that I want to touch today. The labs are able to give us really beautiful processes on night bruxism and night grinding. I have developed sensitivity also. Can you please guide me? Hello, Ms. Sai Jyoti. Thank you for joining us here. Thank you, friends. Thank you for joining us. Your likes and your hearts flowing really keeps my spirits high. Thank you so much for this. I want to answer these questions here. Mr. Rahim, what I would suggest is something called as a night guard. Night guard is something like this. Let me show you a picture of a night guard here. Let me first show you the picture and then, you know, I'll be able to explain you better what a night guard, how it functions. It's actually a thin, around 1.5 millimeters transparent acrylic material or a plastic material that is fabricated in the labs. So what we do is, the first thing is that we take impressions of your upper and your lower arch. I prefer night guard for the upper arch, mainly is because the tongue is not there at all. And you know, if you make night guards for the lower arch, the tongue definitely feels that there is something alien in the mouth. In the upper arch, it is much more comfortable to wear a night guard. So what happens in bruxism? As you'd ask me, bruxism mainly means grinding or clenching of your teeth. There could be many reasons for bruxism. You know, could be stress related. When people are in stress, they have this involuntary movement or the grinding or the rubbing of the teeth. When people are in their short temper or they're in anger, sometimes they rub or grind their teeth. Or as night bruxism, as one of the viewers has asked us here. So in bruxism, what happens is because of the grinding, the upper enamel layer is lost. The white color enamel layer is lost and the dentine or the second layer comes, is exposed. That's the reason you feel sensitive. So basically night guard protects your teeth from the strong vertical forces of grinding. They protect your teeth from sensitivity. They protect your teeth from being cracked or breakage. And a very good appliance called as a night guard can be given. Night guard does two things. One, it protects your teeth. Secondly, if you use it regularly on a long-term basis, you wear it at night and sleep, it also breaks your habit. So night guard is also a habit-breaking appliance. So it's a dual appliance. And any more questions? Yes. Miss Poonam, her uncle is 40 years old and has spaces between his teeth. Can he undergo clip treatment at this age? Yes, absolutely, Miss Poonam. Thank you for asking this question. That's a nice question. Yes, you can undergo clip treatment even at 40 years of age. What we do is we basically take an OPG to assess the quality of the bone and the quantity of the bone that we have. For any clip treatment or any ortho treatment, what we mainly require is a good bone support, right? A good bone support, if available, any age is not a contraindication. Spaces in between the teeth can absolutely be dealt with, and ortho treatment takes approximately 10 months to about a year. We have different modalities of ortho treatment. Parthodontal has a amazing orthodontic team, I would say. The HOD Parthodontal, HOD Orthodontics of Parthodontal, Dr. Indraneel is also the one who is, enlightening all our viewers with his knowledge of orthodontics. He has an amazing team support and we have Parthodontal, I would say that we have dealt with the highest number of braces or clip treatment cases. In a month, we do approximately 2 to 2,500 cases every month at Partha Dental, and we help people align their teeth properly. Another question here, my teeth are white, but as I'm aging, they're becoming dull and yellow. Please guide. Yes, another related question here is also, how many sittings do I need for tooth whitening? Yes, thank you for asking these questions. Thank you, everybody. So both of these questions, I will have a similar answer. Once you feel that there is dullness or there is that sparkle is not there with aging, there is something called as teeth whitening or teeth bleaching. The way you can bleach your face, you can even bleach your teeth. And there are two types of bleach procedures that we usually follow. I like the office bleach procedure. It approximately takes 1 hour. And you can whiten your teeth. Let me show you a couple of pictures here in office bleach. I'll show you a couple of pictures here. You know, what is that bleaching can do for you actually? I think let me reduce the brightness here because you're not able to appreciate the results. Is this better? So what bleaching can actually do, we use peroxide agents. You know, we use peroxide agents. This is a similar case, I think, that we were being asked about bleaching or tooth whitening. So in approximately 1 hour, which means around 3 to 4 sessions of 15 minutes each, we can whiten or we can bleach the teeth. The agents used are mostly peroxide, carbamide peroxide, 37% agents. We freshly prepare them, freshly mix them. The first thing is that we completely save your gums. We use gingival guards so that the gums can absolutely be safeguarded from the carbamide peroxide material. And then we take a record of your smile line. Usually the upper six or the upper eight teeth are mostly visible, and the lower eight. So the upper eight and the lower teeth are what they are mostly bleached. So bleaching could be an office bleach procedure, which requires 1 hour. The instructions usually that we give after bleaching is that please stay on white foods for the next couple of days or maximum a week. Because the turmeric powder, जो हल्दी होती है हमारे खाने में और जो लाल मिर्ची use करते हैं वो उनसे थोड़ी सी bleaching results hamper हो सकते हैं. तो मैं अपने हर ब्लीचिंग पेशेंट को कहती हूँ कि आप थोड़ा सी अवॉइड करें हल्दी पाउडर और लाल मिर्ची पाउडर अपने खाने में, ताकि आपके जो ब्लीचिंग रिजल्ट्स हैं वो ज्यादा देर तक रहे. दूसरी एक और चीज जो हम मेंटेन कर सकते हैं आपके ब्लीचिंग प्रोसीजर, वो है होम ब्लीच से. सो मैं आपको दिखाती हूँ होम ब्लीच में हम क्या करते हैं. हम इम्प्रेशन ले लेते हैं पेशेंट के ऊपर और नीचे के दांतों के, और हम उनको ट्रेस बना कर देते हैं. These are called as bleaching trays, right? So, can everybody appreciate that? So, these are called as bleaching trays. The patient can take the material, you know, pour it on the bleaching trays, and you know, place it in the mouth while watching TV, while cooking. You know, you can use this bleaching trays at home for 10 to 15 minutes, and use it for a little prolonged time for about maybe 2 weeks, and you will see the visible changes. There are a lot of products that are available in the market which tell you about bleaching, but I would say out of all these options of office bleach, home bleach, and the products available, office bleach is the most successful, and the patient walks out with a very nice smile. So, at what age should a child start seeing a dentist, and what age should the milk teeth fall? Also wanted to know if the braces are indicated for kids as young as 8 years old. Yes, so I will suggest that when you see a lot of, I have seen in my practice, I have seen patients as young as 2 years also. So if the parents are aware enough, if the parents are educated or aware enough that yes, usually the milk teeth, they start to erupt at 6 months of age. That's the first time that we see the lower milk teeth erupting. And if the parents are aware enough, you know, they should start cleaning the teeth during bathing the children or during rinsing of after every meal. You know, they should take care about it. So usually I will recommend around 3 years of age is what usually you should start, the child should start seeing a dentist. And milk teeth, they start falling by the age of 6 to 6.5 years. People have to be more aware about the importance of milk teeth. बहुत लोग मुझे कहते हैं कि अगर ये दूध का ही दांत है, दूध का दांत मतलब अगर ये मिल्क दांत ही है तो हम इसमें क्यों कैविटी फिलिंग्स करवाएं, हम इसको ऐसे ही रहने देते हैं. बट अगर दूध के दांतों की आप इम्पोर्टेंस नहीं रखेंगे, एक तो वन आपका बच्चा जो है वो हमेशा केयरलेस ही रहेगा अपने परमानेंट टीथ के साथ भी, तो इसीलिए दूध के दांतों की इम्पोर्टेंस हमेशा होनी चाहिए. आपको रेगुलरली डेंटिस्ट के पास जाना चाहिए. अगर कुछ कैविटीज या कुछ है तो आप उनको टाइम से भरवाएं. दूध के दांत एक पर्टिकुलर टाइम पे गिरते हैं. अगर वो एक टाइम से पहले गिरे या टाइम से बाद गिरे, सो इवन इफ दे आर रिटेन्ड फॉर अ लॉन्गर टाइम और दे फॉल ऑफ बिफोर टाइम, देन यस देयर इज स्पेसिंग प्रॉब्लम्स दैट कैन बी सीन इन द परमानेंट टीथ. Usually, braces are not indicated for kids as young as 8 years old, but we have growth modifiers. Growth modifiers is something, so at that age of 8 to 12 years, the maxilla or the upper bone and the lower mandible bone, you know, they are still at a growing age. So when the orthodontist or any general dentist is also able to foresee that yes, there could be some discrepancy in the alignment of the teeth, they can recommend you growth modifiers. they are very easily, you know, we just take the impressions, upper and the lower impressions. We send it to the laboratories. Let me show you some pictures of growth modifiers here. We send it to the laboratory and the growth modifiers can be used by the patients, by the kids. Sorry, I have some more questions. I'll just get to that picture again. Braces weaken the teeth. What do you have to say about it? Thank you for asking this question, ma'am. Always before we do any kind of dental treatments, we always take a good diagnostic x-ray called an OPG x-ray. An OPG x-ray will tell us about the quality and the quantity of the bone that is available to us, and whether we have to go ahead with the braces treatment or not. That's again a complete myth, ma'am, I would say. That's a misconception that braces treatment leads to weakening of the teeth. There is nothing like that. Once the teeth are rotated or aligned along with braces, then after we remove the braces, the periodontal ligaments have their reparative capacity, and the gums, they all again tighten or hold the tooth back in position. So braces treatment does not weaken the tooth at all. Yes, thyroid. Some people who have thyroid problem, you know, hypothyroid or a hyperthyroid patient, they have to keep their levels of T3, T4, TSH in control for you to have a successful orthodontic treatment. Yes. Another question here, success rate of dental implants and what if dental implants fail? Yes, in Partha Dental, I can boast, proudly boast, I can announce that yes, 96%, 95 to 96% of our dental implant cases have been successful. From a two-piece implant, we have now started to use one-piece implants. We have also started to do intraoral welding of implants. Let me show you an interesting case here, Mr. Zakir Bhai, which the success of an implant depends a lot upon the dentist who is doing the implants. As I told you, we have an excellent team effort here, you know, excellent teamwork here that can be done. And, you know, we have something called as intraoral welding machines. Even the micro, the first 28 days of placing an implant are the most critical for any patient for us. So we also weld the implants so that the vertical movement or the rotatory movements are completely gone. The welding procedure of the implants really help to keep the implants in place to osseointegrate them properly with our body tissues. And hence the failure rate reduces drastically. I would like to show you some picture on intraoral welding. That's a really beautiful technology that is there in Partha Dental here. And sorry about taking this time of finding my case. That's a beautiful case what was done by our team over here. And I want to show this case to you all here. So if you see the implants and you see a horizontal bar, that's called the intraoral, that's called the welding of implants done by an intraoral welding machine. Right, and this completely stops the micro movements of the implants and hence a success rate. So inside the mouth, this is how it looks like. This was a case done in Gachibowli branch last week, where this patient came to us. She was wearing dentures for the past 6 years. And she's a 62-year-old lady with a good medical history. And she came to us because she was wearing denture for the past, 6 to 8 years. And Of course, the dentures, the problem with dentures is that it loses with time. You know, there is a bone loss that happens and the dentures become loose with time. So eventually, you know, she was fed up of those removable dentures and she wanted a fixed treatment in her mouth. So we gave her 8 implants for the lower and 8 implants for the upper arch. And my implantologist welded these implants for the best success rate of these implants. I would like to reintroduce myself here. Hello friends, this is Dr. Abhiruchi Gupta. I am a senior cosmetic dental surgeon working for Partha Dental for the past 4 years. I have 17 years of work experience and Partha Dental is growing and spreading its wings all over south of India now. We have 84 branches. Partha Dental has each and every type of facility, each and every type, the best infrastructure available, the best clinicians and the best super specialist team available to render their services to all the people who would like to have it. So the program over here for Facebook Chat Live is to create that dental awareness. Please walk into Partha Dental Centers. Partha Dental Centers are available literally in every nook and corner. Now I would say we are spreading widely. The main motto to have these practices of Partha Dental is to render services to all the patients and all the people and create dental awareness amongst them. Dental hygiene or dental fitness is a should be inculcated as a very, very important part of our lives. A healthy mind, a healthy mouth definitely will lead to a healthy body. There are certain procedures that, you know, as I told you, I would like to also talk about a little bit procedures that we give in the labs. You know, night guard was one of them, where a viewer asked us about this bruxism or the night grinding habit, and I told them that a night guard can be given. Another lab procedure that I could whiten their teeth. I showed the bleaching trays that are also again made in the lab, that the lab helps us in making those trays and we can eventually, you know, give it to our patients. A couple of questions here. Doctor, can you suggest some procedures to increase the gum height? Thank you for asking this question. So basically, a lot of people sometimes are conscious about the way they smile because when they smile, you know, the high gum line shows. So to remove that gummy smile you have to increase the gum height. Okay, so increasing of the gum height can be done by either gingivoplasty or gingivectomy. You know, Partha Dental uses laser technology to do these procedures. We just have to anesthetize the patient and we use soft tissue lasers to do this procedure, and it hardly takes approximately 5 to 6 minutes to increase the gum height. Some people who feel that question now by Miss Manu. Doctor, my daughter's teeth are crooked. She is 10 years old. Can we do braces treatment for her? Yes, Miss Manu Mathur. Yes, we usually start the braces treatment from the age of 12 to 13. Once your first molars have erupted, then we also check on the eruption of the second molars. Between the age of 8 to 12, I will suggest you something called as growth modifiers. So growth modifiers are again appliances which are very simple appliances made in the laboratory. A child can use it. It just has to be adjusted once in the child's mouth, and it basically guides the growth of the jaw. So once the diagnostic x-rays and once the cephalogram, lateral cephalogram or the OPG x-rays are taken, the orthodontist can study the growth that is happening in the maxilla and the mandible and then accordingly give the growth modifiers. Once around age of 12, what you can do is you can give her permanent different types of braces or clip treatments that are available here. We have this, the advanced technology of braces is something called as self-ligating ceramic and metal braces, and we also have lingual braces and Invisalign or Clearpath aligners. So these are the different treatment modalities for braces that we have at Parthal Dental. Another interesting tool I think that is made in the lab is something called as sports mouth guard. Very few people I think are aware of it, and I would like to create this awareness amongst people. Too many tennis academies and cricket academies. A very good tool is something called as a sports mouth guard. You know, anything that basically keeps your teeth in danger of breaking, because by the age of 12 you have all your permanent front incisor teeth, and suppose you have a little rough play, or you have like even like football or basketball or cricket, or you have rugby, or you have soccer or wrestling, in all these the athletes or the players, they should use something called a sports mouth guard. It's a little bit different from a night guard. Night guard only covers a little bit of your teeth, but the sports mouth guard, it covers your jaws and your gums as well, right? So let me show you a picture here. This is another processes that can be made in the dental labs. These are called as sports mouth guards. So sports mouth guard, this is an oral appliance which is prescribed to an athlete to protect his teeth from being damaged by a physical blow on the face or even by an accident. It's usually made of a much thicker material compared to a night guard, and its purpose is to completely cover the entire jaw, right? All the sports lovers, all the athletes, all the sports lover enthusiasts, please do wear sports mouth guards. You know, it actually comes in beautiful colors. You know, if you have any team color, all the team players can get that color made. Or if you have any kind of, you know, any color theme or any jewel colors, you know, it can be done with that as well, right? So The sports mouth guard has a little softer material compared to the other mouth guards, so that it's able to absorb whatever the immediate fall or the immediate accidents, like a shock absorber, right? So that your teeth and your gums and the surrounding areas are taken care, and that shock absorbs the shock, and there is no damage to your teeth and structures around it, right? Another thing that I would like to enlighten my viewers here is something called as anti-snoring devices. One of the patients, they asked here that, you know, the person snores, and it's basically the person who snores does not realize it much, but the person who's sleeping next to the snoring person has a difficult time, right? So we have something called as anti-snoring devices, which are fabricated in the lab, and they are recommended by dentists to patients who snore excessively. Usually you will see that those patients also do a lot of mouth breathing, you know, so the lips, the complete lip closure is not there, or there is a lot of dryness of the lips, or there is a lot of inflammation of the gums, specifically the upper gums. So if you see such symptoms, you know, you can ask the dentist, can ask the patient if they are mouth breathers. And the purpose of this snoring device, you know, is basically what happens, why do people snore? So what happens is the tongue falls back, and you know, the airway is obstructed, so that the breathing is obstructed a little bit. So what these devices they do is they keep the tongue in the correct position. They bring your jaw a little bit in a forward position so that the tongue does not fall back, and the breathing airway is completely open and the breathing happens normally, right? So yes, if you can take away the snoring part, you know, you can have a good lifestyle. Yes, you can. Your energy is definitely restored. You know, you have a better living lifestyle and you have a healthy mind. A simple transparent device, right? This is called as an anti-snoring device. Mostly recognized by orthodontists, again, our specialist team. It reduces the pressure in the nasal area and it improves the breathing, right? So some people who also have a narrow upper jaw, right? Sometimes they may also complain of snoring. Sometimes when we feel that people are snoring, you know, it could also be because of the narrow upper jaw, like, you know, the jaw is narrow and the orthodontics can advise them a rapid maxillary expansion or an expansion device for the upper arch, right? So there is less pressure in the nasal area and eventually the airway is open, the obstruction is less and people breathe better. Eventually the snoring can be, you know, avoided. So this is Dr. Abhiruchi Gupta from Partha Dental. Yes, Partha Dental has 84 branches in the three different states of Telangana, Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. We have around 40 branches in Telangana, 30 branches in Andhra and 15 branches in Bangalore. There are 250 plus doctors and thousands supporting staff to make this organization a successful and a growing one. We would like you to kindly recommend us to your family, your friends, your relatives. Please also recommend us to your community helpers, your working people, community helpers who are not able to, you know, have the access to the internet, who are not able to, you know, take the guidance from us on Facebook, you know, your maids, your drivers, people who work in your work for you every day, you know, guide them, make them also aware about the dental programs that Partha Dental has and tell them to be, you know, at least once in 6 months, they should visit a dentist. They should walk into Partha Dental practices and you can always contact us. All the branches are connected to one single number. You can call this number 040, that's the Hyderabad code, and then 41420000. Any kind of appointments to any of the nearest branches that you have, you know, you can log into parthadental.com, check which are the branches that are nearest to you. You can just walk into those branches. You can even walk in as an, you know, OP or an everyday patient. And, you know, please take appointments, utilize the services of our doctors. There is also a toll-free number, 1-800-102-8686. So all these numbers will make you reach us. All these numbers are basically the guide to a good oral hygiene. All these numbers are basically the guide to the 250 specialist doctors who are there to give you service, who are there to render their services, the skilled people who can basically understand your problems by talking to you, by consulting, by showing you different pictures, different videos, by making you understand why this problem happened, what is the solution, how you should able to now maintain your dental health once it is restored, and how you should avoid having all these problems in the near future. So thank you, viewers. Thank you for joining us here. This is Dr. Abhiruchi Gupta from Partha Dental. I would like to make this a little more interactive. Kindly ask me any type of questions that you have, any type of dental queries or any type of, maybe any of your friends or family would have any dental problems. You can discuss their cases with me as well over here. Yeah? Thank you. Excuse me. A nice change, I think, that all of us have seen, you know, it was in December when we started these programs, and we have also had people who are now coming to us, and you know, they, a lot of people who would want full mouth rehabilitations. Sometimes when you talk about these full mouth rehabilitations, people feel that it's only to do with implants. It's not like that. It's basically any person who is unable to eat food properly, unable to chew food properly. Any person who has these untreated teeth or teeth that are worn down, you know, could be worn down because of aging. It could be worn down because of any grinding habits. It could be worn down because of any kind of accidents or falls that they would have had, right? So, you know, we have some beautiful treatments that can be given. Any teeth where, you know, any person who has a mixture of teeth that are original teeth that are present and teeth, some of the teeth which are missing, right? So, full mouth rehabilitations is not only about implants, but yes, we can give you a mixture of treatments. And we can do root canals and crowns, or we can do root canals and bridges, or we can do implants in certain areas and give you bridges and single crowns. So a multidisciplinary approach is basically a holistic view, and a holistic approach is taken, seen by the doctors first, and then eventually, you know, we give you a couple of line of treatments. I would say that it's not only a single line of treatment that we follow. Some people, you know, who feel that no, this is not what they would want, we have the options of dentures as well. Like people who have lost their teeth since a long time, we also fabricate full mouth upper and lower dentures. Yes, the awareness has been created a lot that people now prefer implant retained dentures. Right, we usually use two or four implants in one jaw, and we are able to fabricate the dentures for them so that they are fixed into their mouth and they are not removable. So all such options are there, and all such facilities are there in Partha Dental. Please kindly avail all these facilities. Please kindly walk into Partha Dental practices and take your appointments on 040-4142-0000. We even have a toll-free number, 1-800-102-8686. And you can also log into parthadental.com and take appointments from us. We have doctors who are regularly, you know, you can take consultation from them online. We are there to completely guide you and help you in any way possible. Parthadental also has a unique facility which no other practice in India has. No other practice in India has actually. We have two main weapons, something called as Bajaj FinServe and Capital Float. Okay. Now, any treatments, these are the two financial institutions which have joined with Partha Dental to make our patients much more comfortable in getting the treatments done. What happens is you don't even have to have a single rupee in your pocket when you come to us. You know, you can just walk in, you know, avail these two financial services and just get the best type or the highest end treatment done for yourself. It's basically, you know, what you have to think, it's your investment on health, right? Any good quality treatment done by good clinician hands and in a good infrastructure will definitely take you a long way. It's basically your investment on health. Bajaj Finance is an institution which does any treatments ranging from 10,000 rupees till 1.5 lakh of rupees. So any treatment that costs 10,000 rupees till 1.5 lakh of rupees, it can be split up into 6 months or 8 months of EMIs at 0% interest rate, right? So suppose you have a treatment of 60,000 rupees, right? So simple. You can split this treatment into you every month, you know, 10,000 rupees will be taken from your bank account. But the treatment is done that very same month. In the very first month, you get your treatment done. You walk out with good sparkling smiles and you walk out confidently. And Bajaj Finance is there to help you. And there is a 0% interest rate, 6 to 8 months of EMIs. Another financial institution that has come forward to club up with Partha Dental is called as Capital Float. Well, they have a really a very simple documentation that's required. You know, you just require your Aadhaar card or your PAN card, right? And you know, just at it really just takes 3 to 4 minutes precisely to, for us to get your loan approved, right? So any treatment ranging from 15,000 rupees to 3 lakh of rupees. So any treatment which is ranging from 15,000 rupees to 3 lakh of rupees can be financed by Capital Float. You can split up your treatment into 3 months, 6 months or 9 months of EMIs. The treatment can be split up into 3 months, 6 months or 9 months of EMIs at 0% interest rate, right? And the treatment can be absolutely started and rendered due, right, at that very minute. Thank you, viewers, for coming here and interacting with us. I would like to make this much more interactive. If you have more questions, please ask us. If your relatives have more questions, you can ask questions from them. And please also make your community helpers, people who work or people who help you in your everyday life, who are not able to access this program or who are not able to watch this program, please guide them also about their dental awareness hygiene and, please guide them that they should walk into Partha Dental Clinics once in 6 months so that we are able to keep everything disease-free. Once the mouth is disease-free, you have a healthy, healthy body. Well, in today's world, I will say that lot of people have been also coming to us in different areas or sections of life where they just sit and they just talk that, doctor, I want something, I need more, I think I need a beautiful smile, right? This word called as smile designing or cosmetic designing, it can be as simple or as easy as a scaling procedure, and it could be as extensive as giving you full mouth crowns or veneers, right? So you should always walk into a Partha Dental place, get a consultation with the doctor. At least you need to understand that what is it that can make you feel better, what is it that can increase your confidence levels, what is it that can make you present in a better manner, right? And we are absolutely here to help you and guide you, right? I would really like it if it could be much more interactive, and I would like to answer a lot of your questions and a lot of your queries, right? Dental tourism is another thing that is coming up in India. A lot of countries like US, UK, Australia, Canada, New Zealand, on all these places, the cost of dental treatment sometimes becomes unaffordable for the patients. The high costs, and sometimes, I have also seen that the appointment scheduling in these countries, they sometimes will give you appointments which are after 2 to 3 weeks. So if anybody who needs any kind of emergency treatments or people who need some kind of immediate attention, right? So all these problems are not seen at Partha Dental. Dental tourism is again, Partha Dental really promotes dental tourism. all the patients, all the people who are living abroad, they can log on to www.parthadental.com and they can take appointments with us, and you know, they can walk into our centers. Our doctors are here to guide them. Our doctors are here to completely do a good consultation and give them a couple of lines of treatment, right? So once the consultation part, once your line of treatment you are thorough with, you know, you can definitely go on and go ahead with your treatments, right? Again, I have my beautiful, pretty doctor colleague, Sarah, here with us, and she will guide you. She is an oral medicine and a radiologist, a maxillofacial radiologist. She is here to guide you much more on dental hygiene. I will be back with you, viewers.
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. This is Saturday today, and I'm Dr. Sara, like my colleague Dr. Abhiruchi just introduced me. I'm Dr. Sara, working for Partha Dental. So today we will be discussing about oral and maxillofacial lesions, what all type of lesions are there in the oral cavity, and the premagnet lesions, basically. So we will start with introduction. What are premalignant lesions? And how do they affect the oral mucosa? And why are they important? So talking about the first, that is the introduction part, what we can say is in our oral cavity, the cheek area, the palate area, the tongue. Now these are the lesions, these are the areas which are covered with the pinkish color surface, which we call as cheeks, as well as the tongue and the palate. So these are the places which are most vulnerable to any kind of white or grayish white or brown color patches. On a normal term, these normal patches, if they are asymptomatic, then they will not be creating any problems at all. But sometimes these asymptomatic patches may lead to more gravier as well as serious conditions. Now these conditions, which ultimately lead to the cancer of the oral mucosa or the oral cavity, are known as premalignant lesions. Okay, everybody. So now I think you have getting a little bit idea of what exactly these oral lesions are and what exactly the oral cavity and everything is concerned about. So let me start by telling you about what are the substances or the food items which will affect the oral cavity. One of the major substances which can affect the oral cavity is nothing but tobacco. Now, I'm sure all of you must be well aware of what a tobacco is and how, in which all forms it is being used in our country as well as elsewhere, throughout the world, I mean. So tobacco, it is used in the form of pan. Then it is used in pipe smoking. Like they fill in those tobacco leaves inside the pipes and then they smoke. What happens is immediately these things do not cause any effect. And people become very habituated to it. They start becoming addicted to them. So through over a span of years and years together, what happens is they start causing changes in our oral cavity. What happens is there is thickness as well as, you know, increase in the color and changes of the color of the cheeks, the palate and the tongue. Because these are the areas of rich blood supply. So what happens is these substances tend to disrupt the blood supply of and form a collagen formation occurs in those areas. And so a whitish layer is formed over it. In normally, a whitish layer forming does not cause any problem, unless it is symptomatic, unless there is burning sensation or there is a kind of reddish lesion or ulceration over it. Let me show you a picture of how tobacco is used in the oral cavity in the form of pipe smoking. Can all of you view it? Yes, this is a common pipe which is used as smoking pipe and tobacco. Can you see? The tobacco leaves are used in that, and that is how a pipe smoking occurs. And one more thing, the most common form of palm chewing as well as betel nut, what we call in layman terms as supari. So what is a supari and how it causes the lesions of the oral cavity? So friends, this is arikaya nut, okay, also known as supari, as well as this. This is the dry form. This is in the dry form. It is crushed and used in the palm, as well as it is used in the dry form. It is used directly taken into the oral cavity and chewed. People become habituated to this. It is an addiction. Usually it is preferred after food. People start chewing tobacco, betel nut after food. Orals, in certain category of people, what they do is they just chew it for time pass. They just keep eating it all again and again. Because it gives them a certain kind of taste. Because here it is mixed up with a lot of preservatives. So basically what happens is, as and how you keep chewing this, it causes changes in your oral cavity. Now, what kind of changes and what these conditions are? Now, let us discuss about that and let me put light on what those conditions are. So basically, there are four major kind of conditions which happen because of chewing of all these tobacco, arikaya nut, as well as alcohol and smoking. So these are the major risk factors which will cause these kind of lesions. So the basic one which occurs is oral submucous fibrosis. Oral submucous fibrosis is a kind of lesion which causes stiffness of your oral mucosa. It leads the person to become anemic, because the person is not able to open his mouth completely. Let me show you a picture of what happens over continuous use of gutkha. Can you see? The mouth opening of this patient has been reduced. So he is not able to open his mouth at all. I think only two or one finger will be able to go inside the mouth. So in such conditions, what happens is taking in food becomes very difficult. And because of this, the person becomes anemic. And because of this, he will not be able to take proper nutrition. And as and how as the span of time goes on, he becomes malnourished, and the proper proteins and nutrients are not going inside. And apart from the oral mucosa getting affected, his entire body. Okay, so I'm sorry for the disruption in between. Okay, let me introduce myself once again. I'm Dr. Sara from Partha Dental, and I'll be talking to you today about the oral cavity and the changes in the oral cavity and the oral mucosa. This is the condition, like I was going to show you a picture. Now this one is how the cavity looks. That is the cheek looks. Can you see the white discoloration of the cheek? Now this white discoloration of the cheek is nothing but hyperpigmentation, that is keratinization, sorry, not hyperpigmentation, but keratinization, thickness of the increase in thickness of the cheeks from inside, and it becomes stiff, rigid. The patient is not able to blow his cheeks. He is not able to blow his cheeks at all because of the stiffness. Just nothing but fibrosis which is occurring in the oral cavity. Now these kind of lesions develop over a span of time. In one day or 2 days, the patient may not be able to detect what is happening with them. So it is always better to come for a dental checkup, not only for your teeth, but also for your oral cavity, the tongue, the surrounding mucosa. Everything is associated with your mouth. Even the uvula of yours, as well as the soft palate, the hard palate, and the teeth, the area, the gums surrounding your teeth. All these are very important part of your mouth. And yes, apart from keeping your teeth healthy, you're supposed to keep the other areas clean as well. Because anything, any small lesion or any kind of a thickness or whitening in the oral cavity might lead to a serious condition which initially may not be detected, but later on it becomes a cancerous stage. So we in Partha Dental over here are a bunch of specialists in each and every field of dentistry. And so we are here to help you in any possible way regarding your oral mucosal problems, regarding small ulcers, or it could be something related to your teeth or related to your gums, anything including the oral cavity as well as the oral and maxillofacial region. So, last I was talking to you about how these lesions look. So, let me show you another picture of how leukoplakia look. Now, it is a white patch in the oral cavity, which happens because of smoking, excessive smoking over a span of more than 5 to 6 years. So, this is how it looks. Can you make out the whitish patches over there? So, this is how leukoplakia looks. And there is one more image over here, leukoplakia on the tongue. This is how the leukoplakia on the tongue looks. Suddenly there is whitish discoloration, and over a span of time it becomes thickened. It becomes uncomfortable. There is change of taste, as well as, you know, fungal infections start getting accumulated in that area, and then you have fungal infections. So it's like one lesion leads to the other. So it is always better to get it detected well in advance. So we always get a checkup. Even though you might be thinking that you are well, your teeth are in good health. Yes, that might be possible. You must be taking good care of your teeth, must be brushing regularly. But apart from that, a dental checkup is always mandatory. Once in 6 months, please do visit and get your dental checkup done. You never know what is happening in which corner of the oral cavity. Even though it looks very small, but there are so many places wherein a small lesion can start off and it might create problems for you. So it is always better to come up and get your dental checkup done. We at Partha Dental over here are always ready to help you in any possible way. Okay, so like I was telling you about these oral mucosal lesions. Now, arecanut, betel nut, as well as tobacco. Now, how these substances cause the oral cavity to become rigid. And there are various changes in the oral mucosa, which will ultimately lead to precancerous lesions. Now, the disadvantage of this is that you should always be coming early for the detection. Because what happens is, over a span of time, if there is late detection, then in this case, it might go for a vast treatment. Now, what happens is, if it is not detected early, then over a span of time, you have to maybe impose to grade 2 or grade 3. Then a cancer kind of a lesion develops. And after that, it's a very great hassle for you to go through all those chemotherapy procedures as well as radiotherapy procedures. So it's always better to take precaution instead of going for the cure later on. And like I was discussing to you about the changes in the oral cavity and how tobacco and smoking affects. Now, alcohol also is one of the factors which leads to changes in the oral cavity. It is said that, according to research, about 1.2% more is the percentage is of people consuming alcohol causing these lesions as compared to the normal smoking, or taking up just the tobacco in the mouth, or chewing the good cuff. So avoid all such substances as less as possible. And then apart from that, please keep your oral mucosa clean. Clean your tongue regularly. You should always take care that there are no white colored lesions on your tongue, like white color patch or a layer of whitish discoloration on your tongue. So it is always advisable that apart from brushing your teeth, you should keep your tongue clean. Because tongue is also the area where in different kind of bacteria have the tendency to get accumulated. So you should also keep your tongue clean. And like I was telling to you about these oral mucosal conditions and how we can treat them. Now, yes, we have a lot of treatment options for these conditions. So it is always good that it gets detected earlier. And so the treatment becomes easy even for you as well as for the condition to get eliminated quickly. Because this condition, which is the oral submucous fibrosis, is an irreversible condition. In case if it goes to the third or the fourth stages, coming back to the original opening of your mouth becomes very difficult. Because there is considerable fibrosis which is happening in the oral cavity, and because of that, what happens is you are not able to open the mouth properly. Even the surgery in certain cases may not help you to come back to your original health, that is the original mouth opening of the normal people, which is somewhere around 40 to 41 millimeters. And so anything that oral cavity, the opening of the mouth reduces, then again there are problems. You're not able to take your food properly inside. You're not able to chew properly. So all these problems are one after the other because of one small lesion. So we at Partharental over here are always there to help you in any way. And I would suggest and I request all of you that please do come to visit Partharental. And we have all branches of specialties over here. All kind of treatment modalities are available. And we are well equipped with all kind of advanced technology. And so the treatment becomes easy for you, as well as the patient will go happy from here. That is for sure a warranty. Okay, so I would like to sign off from here, and my colleague Dr. Abhiruchi will take over now, and I'm sure all of you will be having more number of questions which you would like to ask to her. And please do continue watching our live sessions. Thank you so much. Dr. Abhiruchi will continue now.
Thank you, Dr. Sara. Hello, this is Dr. Abhiruchi back again. Thank you for all the viewers for joining us here. Thank you, Sujata. Thank you, Shiva. Thank you, Mr. Harish. Thank you, Ms. Anu. Thank you, Mr. Ramesh. I would appreciate this to be much more interactive if we can have some more questions from your side. So I have a question over here regarding bone grafting, right? So they asked me that please enlighten me about bone grafting. My bone is weak and I would like to get implants, so please tell me about bone grafting. Yes. So we have our maxillofacial surgeons and implantologists who are our super specialists and perfectionists in these procedures. There are different methods of bone grafting. You know, the most successful one is something called as an autograft, where they could take a part of your bone either from the chin area or from the palate area, whatever is suitable, depending upon how much of the bone has to be grafted. We even have bone graft powders, you know, which can be placed in the particular area so that we can get that good enough height. Now, approximately it takes 4 to 6 months for the bone grafts to be accepted in the body and for us to eventually then give you the implants. So I think the patient wanted to go for implants after bone grafting. So that is a good point to know that usually once the bone grafting procedure is done, it does take approximately, we need to wait for 4 to 6 months before your implants can be given. So you have very less bone. That should not be of any concern, because I must tell you that this area of the anterior, the upper anterior area in the maxilla, and the lower area which is there, this has excellent amount of bone, you know, excellent the bone quality, the bone height, and there are no major complications that can actually happen in this area. So there is something called as all on four principle, you know, where we can give you four implants and then we can give you the processes over those implants. So in Partharental, I would say there are no patient is refused of implants. There are hardly any contraindications. Even systemic diseases, like suppose your diabetes is under control, suppose your blood pressure is under control, you know, all implants can definitely be given. So we have another question here. What are the risks associated with dental implant surgery? As I just mentioned here, once your medical condition is completely under control, once your cardiologist or your general physician has given us a green signal, we can absolutely go ahead with implants. I have had a lot of patients in Gachibowli. You know, there is a business person, you know, I think he's had a liver transplant, so the patient was really concerned, you know, what about the antibiotics that will be given during the implant procedures, you know, will my liver be able to metabolize those antibiotics, and I hope no problem will happen. But then we've given him beautiful, beautiful set of 6 implants in the lower arch and 6 implants in the upper arch. I had another patient from US, you know, she 82-year-old female patient. She has had a pacemaker in the heart. She has had her knee replacements. She is a diabetic. She is a hypertensive. She is on 5 milligrams of steroids every day of her life for the past 12 years, right? So if you see this medical condition also, my implant, so once everything is under control, right? So we gave her 6 implants, you know, 3 in the lower arch and 3 in the upper arch, because she was not able to chew properly from her right hand side. So, you know, implants are not anything to be scared of. There are hardly any risks or any kind of failures involved. Pathodentals have 95 to 96% of implant success rate in our branches. You know, the doctors have delivered lot of implants and done extremely successful cases. There's another question here. I have heard that the dental implant procedure can take several months to complete. Is that true? What happens in dental implants is that within 24 to 48 hours, we are able to place your dental implants, and we are able to give you a temporary processes so that your the function of the mouth can, you can chew and eat properly, right? So it does take your body, it does take your body does take some time to osseointegrate with that implants, but the function part of the mouth is completely, you know, taken care of, so that the discomfort or the basic purpose of getting the implant is not defeated, right? We deliver the temporary processes or the within 24 to 48 hours, so that your basic purpose of getting an implant, your basic purpose of replacing the missing tooth and letting it into function, that starts happening, right? I have another question here. Can I get implants after bone grafting? Yes, one can get implants after bone grafting. The bone grafting takes approximately 4 to 6 months to be osseointegrated and accepted in the body. And then once that is a successfully done procedure, then after that, the implants can be placed. As I said, that even if the bones are, you know, they are a little less or less in height at the back area region, you can have beautiful 4 to 6 implants placed in your anterior upper maxilla and your lower mandible. And with the support of those 4 implants, we can give you prostheses, you know, 12 teeth here and 12 teeth here. So that can absolutely be done. So nothing to worry if you have weak bones or less bone. So kindly let me know about cosmetology. Okay. And yes, so cosmetic dentistry involves a lot of small, non-invasive, easy procedures, and you can go on to a lot of invasive and elaborate procedures, right? So very some simple things like bleaching, some simple things like tooth jewelry, some simple things like call as laminates or veneers, and you know, simple treatments like crowns or bridges, or simple treatments like braces, right? So all these, according to me, lead to beautiful cosmetic results and beautiful cosmetic procedures. Orthodontics or the braces, I would say, is the most successful natural smile designing procedure. I call orthodontics or clip treatment as a natural smile designing procedure that we are doing at Pathodental with the help of our specialist team of orthodontics, right? So so all these procedures can easily be done, and all these specialists are available at Pathodental. This is Dr. Abhiruchi Gupta from Partha Dental, Hyderabad. And Partha Dental is now becoming large and becoming an extremely ethical organization and an institution. Our basic principle of ethics and our basic principle of rendering services to each and every section of the society has definitely taken us forward in our mission. To walk into any Partha Dental Center, kindly take appointments from us at 040-4142-0000. You can also log on to parthadental.com and have a live chat with doctors who are there and also take guidance from them. You also have a toll-free number of 1-800-102-8686. And you also have a WhatsApp number. So all these are the different ways where you can all connect to us. I would want all of you to have a beautiful and a lovely weekend ahead. And tomorrow, my dear friend, Dr. Aditi Netikar, will be live from you 2 p.m. onwards. Kindly bombard her with all the kind of questions that you have. The whole of next week is pretty interesting, I would say. We have planned a very interesting next week. And I look forward to each and everybody's participation. Please let all the likes, shares, and the hearts flowing. Thank you and bye from Partha Dental, Hyderabad.